will surely face it now how the Archons came here. Why are you here?
We can tell you that too.
We have seen that the Voladors were sent here by the inorganic beings. The inorganics are shadow beings. The Voladors were looking for energy, after a lot of energy. And so the inorganics said, look, there's the earth. There are a lot of people, a lot of energy that they can give you. Go there. And then came the alien invasion Jonathan has already told you about. Afterwards, everyone Volador joined your consciousness. Everyone get its own Volador. They feed on your energy. It keeps you alive so that you can exist. But it do not want, of course, that you may have accumulated enough awareness or energy. That's why all the wars, the suffering, the daily small or big problems. As soon as you have accumulated some awareness, it eats them away again. It does this by going into your problems. By doing this, it identifies you with your problems and you live according to your uncontrolled emotions. So the Voladores' trick is always to project your present focus into the future or past. For example, dissatisfaction can arise. Or you feel unhappy out of nothing because you don't have something that could be possible in the future. Or because you don't have something when you may have been happy in the past. So you always shift your consciousness to another time. And you don't stay in the present. Because you would be completely in the present, the changes in reality would also be noticed and registered. And you would know, now I am in this reality and now I am in that reality. Because of the many realities that one perceives, you can combine them. This would make it possible to recognize the larger picture or to make contact with the higher self. The contact with the higher self is, of course, not so favorable for the Voladores, because then you would recognize that it creates your self-image and ensures that you are not centered in the present completely. You are wondering now who these inorganic beings are. The inorganic beings are the one who created the Matrix. They are long, very thin, shadowy once beings. The inorganic beings work together with the Voladores because the Voladores ensure that the self-image is maintained. That means you can think about yourself, but you can't really expand your awareness. If you accumulate your awareness, everything will be removed by our little problems and the energy is consumed by the Voladores. This ensures that you limit yourself just to your self-image. And it ensures that you only recognize yourself to the extent that you define yourself in everyday life. So, as the ego personality that you think you are. And this ego personality is actually your self-image that you have. In addition, you actually don't know who you really are. We are the higher self too. All of the alternative realities in which we exist again are all of us. However, we have no consciousness and no memory at all that we are these other personalities as well. There are, of course, ways to get rid of the Voladores, the ego. Everyone talks about integrating the ego. In my opinion, the Voladores should be complete. Get rid of the Voladores, however, completely get rid of it. That means using techniques to send them away from us. And that's exactly what is possible. The Voladores has only one entrance to human consciousness, and this happens by thinking. That actually means, as long as you think and think about your self-image, it is possible that the Voladores is fed with your energy simultaneously, or fed with your consciousness. This can be prevented by learning to switch off your reason temporarily.
That's what we call dissociation. If you fail to think for 10 minutes, the voladores will disappear, because it doesn't like it at all. It may come back after a while, but it is very weak. If you do it again and do it again, it will go forever. Thus you free your consciousness from the voladores. Then you can recognize yourself living in many parallel realities in which you are alongside. And you can accumulate as much awareness or expand your awareness so far that you can do all sorts of things and to receive any information. For example, to achieve out-of-body experiences and lucid dreams. Or you have perceptions about an activated pineal gland or even how to leave the matrix. I agree, because that's one of the important points to get rid of the voladores to leave the matrix. Of course, the voladores doesn't like that when trying to expand your awareness. Of course, it always causes conflicts in everyday life. You think you don't have enough money, or you think you're not loved enough, or you don't have enough to do whatever you'd like to do. You simply don't have enough. And in this way, the voladores continually stirs up conflicts with yourself or with others, just so you don't expand your consciousness. This dissociation, on your hand, ensures that the mind or reason is temporarily deactivated. And as soon as that happens, you perceive your world without the voladores. And then you can see reality as it really is. From my own experience, I can tell when the voladores is gone, there are no more emotions. There are no lower emotions like anger, hatred, grief, pain or whatever. There is no more jealousy, no envy. Then there is no longer any definition of yourself. There is no past. There is no future. There is just the now. You are uncontrollable. There is no thought telling you this is so and so and you have to do this and that now. You don't perceive it as yourself. There is no longer any kind of identification. It's completely gone. So that your self-image then is actually dissolved. Access to your long-term memory is then temporarily deactivated, so you can't not recall your self-image. At the same time, you can no longer call up the filter which just camouflage the change between realities. Dissociation is the trick. In my opinion, the only trick that ensures that the voladores can no longer take any action. The voladores can only act by thinking. There is another option for me, which of course is far less effective than dissociation. For me, that's joy and the here and now. If you are in joy, that's real joy. Don't have fun or it's so funny, but real joy from the heart. Then you are practically in the here and now. Then there are actually non-thoughts more. It takes a lot longer than dissociation. You can of course also collect energy in this way. Yes, through joy and being happy you can also raise your energy level. So you can expand your awareness or your consciousness a bit. At that moment the voladores has much less access to your mind, because you are in joy and thus in the here and now. In one of the following videos, we will tell you how exactly the image is structured, what the aspects belong to and so on, what all the voices are in your head, where you think they are yourself. Of course, we also explain how the dissociation works and how to achieve it. Dissociation is a very powerful and energetic technique. Once you have learned the dissociation, it is difficult to learn, but it's possible. And by dissociating, you can accumulate so much energy that the voladores is temporarily deactivated. Or you can even make the voladores disappear completely. At www.matrixa.com or www.matrixa.com dot brainwave minus binaural minus beats.com in our shop. We also created a video for you. With this you can practice and learn the dissociation with a technique that you can use so that you can get rid of the voladors and calm your ego or just relax more. It is definitely a very effective technique. This will cause you to stop the mind. It is not just a guide. It is a practical video with practice. The exercises take about 1 hour. There is also a video with instructions on how to use the technique. And then you follow the video into the silence. Since you can practice rigorously to achieve dissociation, you can also wait for the next video where we will explain it to you in more detail. For those who want to get started right away, you can have a look in the shop. We have put together a video. You can practice dissociation there. I agree. It is actually a training video that helps a lot. It helps to get used to the feeling of being in dissociation. Maybe you can do it too already over video. That would be great, of course. Otherwise, watch our explanation in the next video. So, dear ones, that it is for this video. We look forward to your questions and suggestions and comments. You could like to post it under the video. We say goodbye for today and wish you a very wonderful weekend. Yes, a wonderful weekend, and hopefully see you soon.